This stuff is all, it's empty hands, right? It's empty hands versus a knife, but these motions that you're learning here, that comes from knife training. All these movements that you're doing, they come from weaponry. It's not a separate system for empty hands, right? That's why we started with weaponry first, is, you know, if you're learning to do knife versus knife cover fence, you know, let's say he's in this grip and you're in this grip, you know, this is what you're running through. And what's the next one? You do two, and you do this, and then you do that, bang, and then you do this, right? That's when you're learning in the beginning. But later on, you want to run away and attack simultaneously. And then eventually, that transfers to your empty hands. That's why we have this, and then usually some kind of slap, you have that, and then same thing. If somebody's trying to teach you empty hand versus knife, and they're teaching you all this fancy strip, that's too much work. If you were caught by surprise, and you know, somebody attacked, you need to be able to hit immediately and create space and get to your own weapon, if you have to have your own, right? Your own carry weapon. A straight arm assault, and does that, you know, I hit, and then I run away, and I get my knife. I fall. Right? A Facebook gang, and that happens, boom, see? I'm going to use my phone to smack you now in your hand. So, again, that's the same mechanic, you know, whatever, boom, boom, and I run. And then maybe, I don't know, maybe if I'm still carrying my own knife, at that moment, you know, I am Facebooking on something. Bang, bang! Mm. Well, see? I can still access my knife. Most people don't carry a knife, right? They just have their empty hands. You know, later on you can add variations, like throws, right? Right now you guys did no throws. It's just, it's this, and then this, and then this. Right? Later on, you can here, hit that, maybe that. Right? Again, it could come from any point. Maybe from the inside. Right? I did this and he decided to go high. So now I gotta deal with that. If I have enough dexterity and training that I'm able to do that, that's what I'll do, right? But again, most likely, if that happens, he thrusts and I'm caught inside, the slap, and he running away, something like that.